You may now begin your presentation.
Over the past 9 years, KCI Enactus has developed a wide range of social enterprises, ranging from designing a cult for the homeless that converts into a sleep lab, to teaching women in the Philippines how to design jewelry out of waste materials. We have harnessed our team's experience, learned from their mistakes, and channeled this knowledge to create a portfolio of 7 innovative and sustainable projects.
This year, we've renewed our focus to have a deeper impact on our local community of London. One of our projects, Branch, takes apples that will otherwise go to waste and converts them into tasty crisps. This project reduces food waste while also providing refugees with the relevant training, qualifications, and work experience they need to secure future employment in the UK. So far, we have started a needs and wants assessment with 4 refugees and are focusing on building trust and rapport before integrating them into the business.
Our 53 members are a diverse range of students who bring a range of experiences to find solutions to both global and local issues. In addition to Branch, we currently have 3 brand new local projects in our incubator, which will broaden our impact across London. Internationally, we also have 3 other international enterprises, one of which is WomenAble. WomenAble this year has impacted 60 Indian women by increasing their income, as the traditional tribal arts can now be sold in new markets. But here with you today, we want to share with you the story of our most established international project, Light Mountain, based in Tanzania.
Hi, I'm Clara, the project leader of Light Mountain. My fellow Enactus KCI members, Jenny, Kathy, and Emma, are going to tell you more about our project. But first, I want to tell you a bit about why I'm so passionate about Light Mountain. I joined the project at its very beginning, 3 years ago, and watching it grow and develop into a truly sustainable solution has been extremely exciting. For the first 2 years, we focused on developing our business model, securing funding, and piloting our ideas. This means that in this last Enactus year, we've been able to implement a life-changing project that we know works. We always strive to improve the impact of our project and make it the best fit for the communities we work with. And I really hope by the end of this presentation, you'll feel as passionately about Light Mountain as my team and I do. But I will let the presenters tell you more.
Let me introduce to you the village of Mkayu, based in rural Tanzania, an hour and a half drive from the nearest town. In rural villages across Tanzania, mortality rates are high. Poverty is the norm, and families struggle on a daily basis. This is because daily household incomes are only enough to cover the most basic of living expenses, making it impossible to save or send your children to school. When we were made aware of this issue, we knew we had to make a difference.
After our team conducted more thorough research, we found out that in rural Tanzania, household air pollution from inefficient cooking methods was a huge problem that takes over 20,000 lives a year. It's no wonder the mortality rate is so high. Breathing in the smoke emitted from these cooking methods equates to smoking 50 cigarettes a day. As well as having a negative health implication, they also damage the environment by requiring wood for fuel, which contributes to mass deforestation. There's also a large economic burden to families, costing almost 25% of the monthly household income on fuel, which is the equivalent to an average Londoner spending £500 on energy every single month.
To understand more, we partnered with our local NGO, Bada Vision Tanzania. They confirmed to us our research but informed us of another need in the community. Women earn an average 3 times less than their male counterparts. One such woman is our beneficiary, Mwana Hemisi. With the help of our project partner, we conducted our needs and wants assessments through questionnaires, interviews, and surveys with the local community. In addition to our partnership with the NGO, we invested time in building relationships with the village leaders to better integrate ourselves in the community and understand the needs. It is through this rigorous needs and assessment process where we identified our 7 beneficiaries, including Mwana Hemisi. These 7 women all earn significantly less than their male counterparts and can only contribute minimally to household income through farming, which is highly dependent on good weather conditions. We recognize that these 7 women have the drive and determination to better their situation, which make them ideal beneficiaries for our project.
To meet both the needs of the woman for a sustainable source of income and the very immediate need for cleaner cooking solutions, we created Light Mountain, our clean cook stove project. We knew we required a very immediate response to the significant health and financial implications the existing poor quality cook stoves were having on the community of Mkayuni. Since alternative cook stoves were not available and the costs were extremely high, our solution was to create a cooperative of 7 women, including Mwana Hemisi, and train them to become entrepreneurs who could then sell on imported clean cook stoves to their community.
We sourced the EnviroFit stove, which compared to the locally available stoves uses 50% less fuel, halves the emissions of harmful gases, and has a shelf life of 5 years. Since a store of this high quality was not affordable to the poorest household, our solution was to create a microfinance monthly repayment plan.
This is how the business model works. We buy the stoves in bulk at a price of £12 per stove. Moan Hemisi then sells it on for £18, charging local households £3 a month for a total of 6 months. This is now affordable to them as they're making savings on fuel. The entrepreneurs make a profit of £6 per stove after they repair back the initial cost.
On our first implementation trip in September 2016, in collaboration with an NGO, we provided detailed entrepreneurship training for our cooperative. This was delivered through detailed and interactive workshops and role plays and covered topics such as marketing, leadership, sales and finance. In addition, with the help of our NGO for translations, we further created a detailed entrepreneurship guide. We further used a series of group exercises to track their progress to ensure they understood the techniques we taught them.
As a cooperative, Moan Hemisi and the other entrepreneurs each took on different roles, such as an accountant to keep track of sales. This detailed record keeping allowed us to see just how well their sales were doing.
Since September 2016, we are pleased to say Moana Hemisi and her cooperative went on to sell 80 stoves under our affordable repayment plan. More importantly, this is her story in her words.
Kuhusu majiko wateja wameyapenda na hamna shida yoyote. Kila unakwenda yani siku ile ya kudai hela hamna mtu alikuwa anamkia labda jiko bovu au linanisumbua hivi wala hivi na hamna. Kila mtu ameyapenda tu yale majiko.
Moan Hemisi has increased her income by 60%, which means she's no longer dependent on her husband for income nor the unpredictability of the harvest. For the first time in her life, Moan Hemisi and her family have been lifted up and above the poverty line.
Moan Hemisi's story is inspiring, but this year at Light Mounted, we've empowered 7 women to become entrepreneurs. As a cooperative, they all benefited from the stove-selling experience and were able to contribute to their household incomes. But this impact is greater than these 7 women. Because they sold 80 stoves, 80 households, which constitutes the 431 individuals, now make savings on fuel and have had their household air pollution in their homes greatly reduced, which drastically improves their lives.
Selling 80 stoves provided our 7 female entrepreneurs with a life-changing income for the 6-month period that they received repayments. However, we found that our entrepreneurs were having a difficult time in chasing repayments from their customers, and we wanted to provide them with a more secure source of income whilst making the enterprise more impactful and more sustainable. So,
during our trip in 2016, we went to the town of Morogoro when we met up with Majuto, who was a local traditional stove manufacturer who was struggling to retail stoves in his town because of the highly saturated market. We conducted a needs and wants assessment by having informal discussions with him. He works in a very loud communal workshop, which means unfortunately he can't hear him in his own words, but this is what he told us.
There are 5, sometimes 18 men making stoves. We wish to move somewhere else, but we don't have the capital. I work hard to eat and survive, but only make 200 to 300 shillings, about 10p profit per stove.
This 10p profit per stove was barely enough to cover the cost of materials he needed to produce stove the very next day, and meant that he struggled to buy food for his family. We recognised Majuto was highly skilled, but he lacked a competitive stove and the entrepreneurial knowledge he needed to convert his informal workshop into a successful business.
To meet the needs of both Majuto for a higher income and our female cooperative for a source of locally cheaper stoves, we decided to design our own brand new clean stoves. Because Majuto was already working with a locally made design, we knew we could use his stove as the basis of our design. We brought one of his stoves back to the UK and had it tested by a professor. Our entrepreneurial approach centers around collaboration. And with the help of a business advisor, who is an engineer, we tested, redesigned, and improved a model, creating a model stove made out of completely locally available material.
Our completely new design is featured here, and it is made from 95% recycled and natural materials. Through testing, we know that our stove is 60% more efficient than the stove Majuto was previously manufacturing. On our trip to Tanzania in February 2017, we taught Majuto how to manufacture the stove, as he had already been selling the stoves in his local community. We made sure to teach him the positive elements of the new stoves so that he could revamp his sales pitch.
The new stoves cost £1.25 to make and can be sold at a price of £3.60 due to their high quality and efficiency. So far, Majuto has begun piloting the production process, and within the next few weeks, we plan to provide investment to kickstart the production of 20 new stoves. selling these new stoves, Majuto's profit margin has now increased by 2,000%. In addition to increasing his profit margin, we've also given Majuto access to new markets by having Moana Hamisi and her cooperative retail their stoves in their village. Because our stove is 5 times cheaper than the old one, it means that it is affordable and accessible to all 2,000 households in Moana Hamisi's village, meaning there is no need for an affordable repayment plan, as the low cost means that it can be paid for upfront.
We are very proud of the impact the new stove design is having on Majuto, but this impact extends more widely than just him. Majuto was not the only stove manufacturer we worked with this year. In total, we've impacted 5 men by teaching them how to make and sell our design. This impact also extends to our cooperative of 7 women. Because the locally made stoves are considerably cheaper than the previously imported ones, it means they can now retail these stoves in a single payment, giving them a more reliable source of income.
There is also a community benefit. Compared to the stove Majuto was previously manufacturing, our stove is more efficient, requiring less fuel, which means households can save an additional £580 a month. This is an 11% increase in the disposable income, money which they can now spend improving their livelihoods.
However, we did not stop there. Through a continuous needs and wants assessment through local surveys of the local community, we found that households were spending 20 to 30% of their income on fuel every single month, depending on which stove they are using. Their primary fuel source is wood charcoal, which is expensive, contributes to deforestation, and releases heavy amounts of carbon dioxide when produced. In addition, this image shows the mass agricultural waste which surrounds Moana Hamisi's village, consisting mostly of discarded rice husks.
To meet both the environmental needs of reducing wood charcoal use, as well as utilizing this agricultural waste, as well as seeing a further opportunity to provide Moana Hamisi and her cooperative with a second source of income, we created our briquette enterprise. Briquettes are a fuel source similar to charcoal in function, but the production process is a lot more environmentally friendly.
To manufacture the briquettes, our entrepreneurs collect the waste, which is free, burn it in our own chimney that we design out of 50% recycled materials, and use the waste from cassava leaves as a binding agent. Once the waste has been burnt and bound, it needs to be pressed into shape. Using the initial stock of payment money, we invested in the briquette press so the entrepreneurs could begin production immediately. But you know what? We do not stop there. We created our own briquette press made from recycled meat grinders, which can be used in the future. As we're using local waste resources that cost nothing, it means we have no running costs, only startup costs. Afio Jikoni, Swahili for clean kitchen, was the name our female entrepreneurs chose to retail their locally available stoves and briquettes.
Our entrepreneurs have commenced production and selling the briquettes to supplement their income from stove sales. For the community, briquettes are 25% cheaper than wood charcoal, and they burn slower and cleaner. This solution also reduces indoor smoke inhalation and saves users money. Here's what our work this year meant to Moana Hamisi.
This year, Light Mountain has been a huge success. We used this year to implement our business model and always strive to improve whenever we could. We know Light Mountain is sustainable and self-scalable, and in the last year, we've provided clean cooking solutions to 2,000 households.
Due to the success of our payment and the affordability of our local stores, we're able to find an additional 6 new cooperatives in the next few years. Also, we have conducted our needs and wants assessments in Matambe, a neighboring village community, where we should begin implementing Light Mountain in the next few weeks.
We've also partnered with the global organization Rally International, who will help us implement new cooperatives across rural Tanzania. With their confirmed interest, we project that in the next 12 months, our clean fuel solutions could expand to empower an additional 40 entrepreneurs and improve over 2,000 more lives.
But the impact on Moana Hamisi and her cooperative does not stop there. Based on demands for projections for the stoves and briquettes, we predict that our cooperative will earn up to £750 annually each, which is 4 times the average female Tanzanian wage.
Implementing Light Mountain, we are facilitating long-term sustainable change. Our more efficient fuel solutions means the entire community of 2,000 households now has access to clean, safe, and affordable cooking solutions. Over the course of the next year, the savings for the community will total up to £2,700, which is enough to send 45 more children to school. This is what our work at Light Mountain means to the community.
Something quickly on the EnviroFit stove, which was you said it uses 50% less charcoal, and I think you said the previous ones were like smoking 50 cigarettes. What's the sort of environmental impact on someone's health from the EnviroFit stove?
Okay, so to answer your first question, we piloted these two new solutions at the end of February. So we actually just started to implement the production of the locally made stoves and clean charcoal briquettes. So we haven't been able to have an update in the last few weeks due to their remote location, but because our entrepreneurs have all the skills now and all the materials necessary to make the briquettes, we're confident they're starting production. Regarding the stoves, Majuto created three pilot stoves when we were there, and we kept one to bring back to the UK and sold two while we were there to the local community, which allowed us also to estimate the price for the stoves. But we are confident, once again, in the last few weeks we haven't had an update yet, but because you have all the materials and the skills necessary, we're confident you actually produce more. Can you remind me of your second question, sorry?
Tim Brown, AIG, thank you very much, great presentation. You mentioned with the EnviroFit stove that you had some issue with cash collection. I was just wondering, out of the total amount of funds, how much have you lost due to not being able to collect the cash? Are you going to bear that, or are you, will the local people bear that? And I suppose the second part is, how has that changed your strategy around how you look to kind of finance the future projects?
So we received around 70% of the repayments, which is good according to what we thought we would get in the end, but it's completely changed our view on the project, especially because we really wanted to make it much more sustainable and locally made as well, to not negatively impact the local manufacturers. And that's when we went back to the drawing board and really rethought our whole initiative and created the locally made stoves in partnership with our business advisor at Centrica for engineering expertise.
Michael Hastings, KPMG. You're saying that you aim to get 2,000 lives impacted in the course of the next year. 2,000 lives impacted next year. And do you consider that to be the success that you want? And then is that the sustainable conclusion you're seeking, or will you seek to market this remarkable product in other communities?
Yes, so we project the 2,000 flats in Bruce based on the fact that we would implement the project in 6 more communities by the end of the year, which is doable because we have now the funding and the local support to do so. This is not our end goal. Well, the perfect situation would be to then implement this project in many, many more communities across rural Tanzania and also across East Africa, wherever there is a need for this solution.
Hi, Gia Cicerone from Teach First. I'm really curious because you mentioned in your opening statement that one of the key reasons that you discovered in the needs analysis was that they can't save. And then in the conclusion you've mentioned that I believe through EnviroFit, they're now earning 4 times more what the average woman is earning. How are you ensuring that they are able to save given this? Who are you partnering with? What are you doing so that there's great financial management? And do you expect this turnover to be the same with the new stoves, given the 5 times less price?
So just to clarify, our projection of them earning 4 times the average income is based on the sale of these locally made stoves and on the sale of the EnviroFit stove. Secondly, we already conducted an entrepreneurship training to teach them how to sell the stoves, but also we also partner with our local NGO to really teach them how to reinvest within their business and grow according to demand, so that we recruit more women to integrate in the cooperative. And actually, we will use 5% of our revenue to invest in a local development project that we agreed with the local village leader, which will be sanitation facilities for the development community.
Hi, it's Surjit from Amazon. A quick question around what's really unique and different of the technology in your stove that you're being able to make locally? Because we do hear about a few store manufacturers addressing this problem in Africa. Like, so what's the unique technology that's in your stove?